Have you ever heard a weather person say that the mercury is rising and wonder what he or she meant? Well, the weather person was referring to increasing temperatures and the rising mercury in a thermometer. If you've ever taken a close look at a non-digital thermometer, you probably noticed a thin line of a red substance inside of it. The substance may be mercury or alcohol, and it goes up or down inside of a thermometer based on the temperature of objects or matter. There is a scientific explanation for this. Mercury or alcohol expands or spreads out as the temperature increases, which causes it to rise in the thermometer. Mercury also contracts or gets smaller as the temperature decreases, which causes it to move lower on the thermometer. Thermometers have various names to indicate the temperature based on the part of the world you're in, or if you're a scientist. When you watch the news in the United States, the temperature is given in terms of degrees Fahrenheit. However, if you travel in Europe or other parts of the world, weather persons will describe the temperature as degrees Celsius. A scientist conducting experiments in a lab may use another term to describe temperature, called Kelvin. Temperatures are used to describe the freezing points and boiling points of material, which are represented by different numbers of measurement on the Fahrenheit, Celsius, or Kelvin scales. Have you ever noticed that pots used to cook food on a stove are usually made of some type of metal, such as aluminum? This has something to do with conductivity. Metals, such as aluminum, are good conductors, which means that heat can easily be transferred and moved through them. This is why they make great materials for cooking, because they can get very hot and won't melt. The metal of a pot can be measured by its conductivity, or how well it can transfer and move heat energy. When two objects come into contact, heat moves from the warmer object to the cooler object. You can measure the heat in the objects by using a unit of measurement called calories. Heat can also be measured as a British thermal unit, BTU. In addition, joules is another unit of measurement for heat. Have you ever made a delicious glass of lemonade? Your ingredients probably included water, lemon juice, and sugar. This mixture is known as a solution because the lemon juice and sugar dissolve or break down and become part of the water. Solutions have two parts, known as the solute and the solvent. Sugar is considered a solute in lemonade because it dissolves or breaks down into the water. The water is considered the solvent because it's the stuff that the sugar dissolves into. Lemonade can be measured by its solubility, or how much of a solute can dissolve into the solvent. Scientists measure solubility of substances based on a liter measurement. So, if you have 1 liter of lemonade, its solubility is the amount of sugar that can be added to the water and still dissolve. When you can't see the sugar particles separated in the water, the sugar has dissolved. However, if you add too much sugar, it will not dissolve and will end up as a large chunk that settles at the bottom of the container. A thermometer is used to measure the temperature of objects in degrees of Fahrenheit, Celsius, or Kelvin. Objects can also be measured by their conductivity or the transfer of heat, which is measured by BTUs, joules, or calories. Solubility refers to how much solute, like sugar, can dissolve into a solvent, such as water.